Good evening and happy St. Patrick's Day. Thank you for taking some time out of your evening and maybe your beer drinking to join Strat and I on In Your Council. Strat Marmarou has been our councilman for 7 years, and we thank him for his service. As always, we are District 4. And before we get down to the nitty-gritty, because he has this fabulous list of things that he wants to inform you about, I just want to give a shout-out to the Reading High basketball team, how proud we are of you. And it was just an awesome run, and you should be so proud. So congrats on all your hard work. Right, Strat?
Right.
Yes,
and
tomorrow they did awesome.
Tomorrow night at 5 o'clock. They'll be in City Park.
Oh, wonderful. So you can kind of a meet
right.
and greet.
Yes.
Oh, nice. Very good. All right.
I don't think I missed more games this year than I ever did because of sickness, but I've been following them for the last 35 years.
Yeah, well, we're very proud of them. We're always proud of them, but
right.
This year especially, they did an outstanding job. So shout out to them.
Let's get on with this agenda.
Yes.
I hope we can get through the whole agenda.
We will. I know we will.
I don't know how many people watch this program. The last time I was on, it was brought up at that time about the relocation of the VA hospital that was at 6th and Walnut at the hospital there for years. Right now, there's a suit pending against the VA by the city of Reading and the citizens of Reading concerning the relocation of the hospital over to Wyomissing. Again, the first time they tried this about 2 years ago, they got caught.
Mm-hmm.
And they were told at that time, you cannot relocate a federal agency out of the county seat. And Reading is a county seat. Now,
yep.
Some people got caught before with a Social Security. They moved the Social Security to Wyomissing, and they were ordered to bring it back the second into the city. The second in Penn. And it's amazing because out of 50 some hundred people that go to this VA clinic here in the city of Reading that are listed in Berks County, 3,800 live in the city.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not accommodating the majority, we're accommodating people that did not want to come into the city. And that's it. Now I was over there, it's a beautiful place, it's out of the way. But I can imagine what that costs to build something like that.
So they didn't go into an existing building. They built this facility.
Yes.
Wow. Okay.
But we're waiting now. We had some paperwork. Well, our congressman at the time, I'll mention his name, Pitts, was contacted as soon as we found out about it. He said he knew nothing about it, which was ridiculous. Now we are communicating with Costello. He's the existing congressman,
okay.
And he's involved with this, and he wants to know exactly what happened. And we're trying to get paperwork that they don't want to give up, but they're going to have to give it up. The court says they have to tell us what they did it, how they did it.
Yeah, that they need to be accountable for that.
Right.
And I find it hard to believe they did not know that they didn't need to stay in the county seat.
They knew.
They knew.
Well, okay. Amendment to the Stadium Commission Ordinance.
Mm-hmm.
We're taking action in regards to the Stadium Commission, not action against the Stadium Commission. We'd like to get additional people on this commission so there's people there when there's a meeting.
Okay.
Okay, that's
what does the Stadium Commission do, just in case?
Well, they oversee. I played ball at the stadium, I umpired at the stadium, I was on the stadium commission, then I became the chairman of the stadium commission for 2 years before I came on city council.
Okay.
Now when I was there, I made sure I had a schedule of all the games, and you as a representative of the city sit on that board, and you should be out there to welcome the people that are coming in, to help them with their needs. There's so much that you can do out there. And, it's not being done.
Okay.
I'll be honest with you, it's not being done. And people are commenting, Strat, since you left, it's not the same. Sorry. I like to see what's going on,
mm-hmm.
and I like the people to know what's going on.
Sure, absolutely.
But it is it's an important job, and it takes a lot of your time. I mean, Now, if there's five or six guys on the commission, you give them each one night. Not the whole night. I used to be there for every game, and I would welcome the people as they came in. Mm-hmm. You remember that guy who used to hawk the books?
No.
He was there a million years, and we were always sitting together. It's nice to greet these people, and you could tell who the visitors are. And they, I think they enjoy being greeted, mm-hmm. coming into a new environment.
Sure.
And I think we should be doing that, and that's what people want us out there for.
Okay, so.
This is a big one. The next one is a big one.
Yes, this is long overdue. When I saw this on your list, I was like, why is it taking this long even?
Well, this is a need for traffic signals at 5th and Olley and 5th and Douglas.
I don't like driving on 5th Street because of those two streets. And I feel badly for the people that live on those streets that need to get on. It's ridiculous.
I must go on 5th Street twice a day.
Yeah.
In the morning, I take my wife to her nurse. Mm-hmm. In town, and I go down Spring and out 5th,
right.
In 5th, south on 5th.
At least Spring has a light.
Yeah. But I've never seen so much double parking on 5th Street. People just double park, get out of their cars, and disappear. Disappear. And that's like that's a super highway.
It is.
That is a gateway.
It's a big gateway.
If this is what we're showing the people what Reading is, it's wrong. It is wrong. Mm-hmm. And I think the PennDOT and some other people, they're going to do a survey and see exactly if lights are needed.
They don't need a survey. I can tell them the lights are
needed. Yeah, well, I tried that out here too at all, right? You remember that?
I do. But they just went ahead and did it, though.
Well, yeah. But I think with all that's being, everybody that's involved this time, I think we may see some good results.
Good.
That's good news. I hope we're going to see some.
Certainly good news for the community,
yes.
the immediate community that lives around there, but then also for the people that need to travel it every day. So,
yes.
Yeah, that's good. That's very good news.
I wish we'd have some people call in when they hear our comments here.
We are live on March 17th, 378-0426. Don't be shy. Strat loves to answer questions. We'd love to take your questions. Oh, we do have a home viewer.
Good.
Okay, that was asking.
That's it.
Hello.
Hello.
Good
how
evening.
How you doing, Councilman Marmarou?
Good evening, Ernie. How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm calling in to let your listeners there know about some new news there with the Water Authority. The board voted last week to waive the fees for bill pay, both through express bill pay, which is $295, and also MoneyGram. If the person goes into MoneyGram, they don't have to pay the $1.50 anymore. That was a extra expense to the Water Authority of about $47,000, but we felt that it was money well spent to give back to the ratepayers, to give them some more options free of charge to pay. It was either that option or build out at the Water Authority and have bill pay out there. But, we decided that the money is better spent by giving it back to the ratepayers instead of spending, $350,000 to build out, plus an additional $280,000 a year for salaries. So that's a win-win for everybody.
Well,
that's great.
I'm one person on council that has backed the Water Authority, especially you, for the tremendous job you do, Ernie. If I could disagree with you, I hope you don't mind.
You can disagree with me. You have before.
I personally would have liked to see a drive-in or drive-up out at the office here on Kutztown Road where you could go and pay your bill. To me, it's easier. And a lot of people out in that area said the same thing. They would enjoy walking out there.
But for me, that's good news because I like to pay my bills online.
Well, I think you're right.
I think you hit the nail on the head there. It's a generational thing.
Yep, very much so.
People in the older generation, they wanted a face to go look at. Still the older generation loves to even go grocery shopping today for something to do. And, we thought about this over a year and had to come to a conclusion, and it was that, we didn't want to spend a lot, but we wanted to do something for the ratepayers, and that was the happy medium. Today, myself, I don't go anywhere to pay a bill anymore. I do it all in my bank account through the Internet. So I know the U.S. Postal Service doesn't want to hear that, but, you know, it's a sign of the times. But it was a well-thought-out process, and we're always happy for your support, Strat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good night now.
Thanks,
right.
Tony. Good night.
Bye-bye.
That's nice. At
it
least
nice.
They're saving people money.
It is.
They're saving
trying
people
to make it convenient. And nobody wants to pay a bill. Let's face it. But it is what it is. So if they're giving us, they're making it a little easier and not giving us, make us pay money to pay our bill online. That's like, really?
Well, you know, I used to love to walk in the courthouse and pay my taxes. I don't. I send a check in for the county and the city taxes and with the receipt and a self-addressed envelope, they send me everything back.
There you go.
That's it.
There you go.
It's worth 44 cents.
Easy peasy. Yes, it is. Okay, so we know the traffic signals. I think you are on the Great American Cleanup next.
Okay. April the 23rd is the Great American Cleanup here in the city of Reading. We do this each year. But up in this area, and again, this is District 4. I'm mm-hmm. from District 4.
Right. Yep.
And District 4, for years, has conducted their own cleanup.
Mm-hmm.
This
yeah.
included Hampden Heights, Hampden Park, 6th and, oh boy, I was at the culvert there on 6th Street.
Yes.
That is a total mess. I mean, I've gone in those weeds,
mm-hmm.
and I don't want to bring up on television the stuff that I took out of there.
No.
I don't want to bring
it up.
I think
we can all imagine.
But whoever does stuff like that, they're pigs.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, they're
mm-hmm.
pigs. Mm-hmm. And take it home. Take it home and put it in the trash. But besides that, the yellow lines are on the city, and especially here at Oran Albright College.
Mm-hmm.
They are going to be repainted. Now, people are saying, you can't give us a ticket because there's no yellow line here anymore. Well, if you understand and you know the state law, you cannot park within 30 feet of an intersection or a curb, or a, you know,
and
driveway.
And honestly, I mean, not everybody knows that or remembers
I know,
that.
I
mean,
know.
I can't sit here and tell you I knew that.
Well,
I knew that. I do follow the yellow lines. But.
What we did in my block, we painted ourselves. We got the paint, and we painted the fire plug.
Okay.
The area around the fire plug.
Mm-hmm.
We even painted the parking spaces in our block.
Wow.
The white spaces?
Yeah.
And we have to tell people what they're for. They don't understand that. And this is primarily the kids from the college.
Okay.
And maybe where they come from, they don't have this stuff. I said, those are stalls, parking stalls.
Mm-hmm.
Like this one girl, she parked over the one stall. One car in two parking spaces.
Yeah.
And she says, you know, that makes sense. I said, that's right. Now someone else gets a parking space.
You're learning something else at college, how to park in between the lines.
It's been a lot better this
good.
Year.
Well, good.
This year, it's a lot. The biggest.
Well, your block is very populated. The block I happen to live in, that's not an issue. But for your block, that's good that you're able to do,
well,
to do that.
Because
you'll get more cars. You have more.
Well, they're trying to come up with a parking program, but I have 26 people living in my block that do not want that parking problem, that parking program. We have 7 houses in that block full of students.
Okay.
Now each student has a car. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And it would not work.
No.
It positively would not work because the people that have homes there and live there all their lives, they're not going to get parking. But they are going to be painting
the lines, yellow lines. That's
around,
awesome.
It's bad around Kelchner Field.
Okay.
It is bad.
Okay.
And those half streets off of Kelchner
yes,
Field.
I know exactly what you mean.
Because
yeah.
the kids park right on the.
Oh, they do. They park right up.
They
park right up to the. Especially when there's night school or there's,
right.
there's the night. I know a
right.
moment at night, and you're always dodging around them. Yeah.
But they're not only going to be painting them there. They're going to be going south, into the city. And taken care of.
Will there be somebody to monitor if somebody parks in them now? Are they going to pay more attention?
The parking authority was told about this before.
Okay.
And their big concern right now is, And I know, being a retired police officer, they stop and talk to me. They know me. Their big concern is expired stickers and expired plates. And it doesn't matter if they're not Pennsylvania plates. Mm-mm. We have an agreement now with New Jersey, Maryland, New York. You get a ticket here. You don't pay that ticket. The ticket is forwarded to the owner in New Jersey, New York, and wherever you come from.
Well, it should be.
And you will pay.
Mm-hmm.
You will pay.
Much more if it has to be forwarded,
yes.
I'm sure.
Oh, yes.
If you waited that long, then that's just going to get nasty.
Again, we were talking about cleanup, and they are going to be cleaning up the entire city. And I wish I had the figures that they gave us last year. Tons and tons and tons of trash that's thrown out by people. They just don't care. They just don't open the window and throw everything out, throw a bag out. Well, I stopped the guy that threw something out from Wawa, and I made him pick it up. See, I still have that police thing.
And well, sure, who you are.
Okay, we're moving. Hey, we are really moving.
Yeah, we're doing well.
The city made a mistake, and I don't want to say it was intentional. Alvernia has gotten so big over there. Around Angelica.
Yep.
And the Conservancy. They're over there with a building. They have a beautiful building. We had leased some land to them and gave some land where it's our property.
Mm-hmm.
But they built there. Now, this one agency that actually looks into things like this says that some of that property that we gave away or leased or whatever, we shouldn't have done that because that was part of that entire Angelica Park.
Okay.
Now, we do have, as a way out, we can now take the amount of property that we did give away to use, which is adjacent. We have other property adjacent to us that isn't part of that. I think we're looking into being able to give some of that land up, and it'll satisfy these people.
Okay.
I mean, they're only doing their job.
Yes.
They're only doing their job.
Yes, and it doesn't sound like anything was intentional. So
no.
You make it right, and that's it.
Go over there and take a look at that ball field now.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yes.
And the driveways and how clean they keep it and everything. Well, let's hope we come up with something that's going to be agreeable to everybody.
Good. It sounds like people are willing to work together on it.
Right.
So I think that's more than half the battle.
Okay, this is the next item is the East End lease agreement. This is a ongoing problem for the last six, 7 years that I've been on council. I brought it up several times. Let's get it resolved. We should get together, get together and get this problem resolved. East End hasn't paid any rental up there, and they've been up there 70 years.
Mm-hmm.
They haven't paid any rent in 6 years. They owe thousands and thousands of dollars. Yes, they do pay for the lighting up there. Well, you want the place lit up for people to come in.
You have to pay the electric bill.
And then they said that they had to repair the roof. Well, I beg to differ with them. I was up looking around, and there's some leaks again. And they did take care of the air conditioning. Well, it's your business. And the heater, and the heat. But again, they haven't paid in 7 years. Now, I'm not anxious to take an organization like with 70 years of service, good service to the community, and kick them out. I won't do that. I positively won't do that. I think we need to come up with something where that property can be utilized for something other than a club. Now, East Ends was a heck of an athletic organization for years and years and years.
Yep.
And they used to have dances up there. They had gatherings. People used to rent the properties. And
you're good.
Viewer?
Hmm?
Viewer?
No. That was just letting us know how much time we
had. Oh, okay.
Keep on trucking, Strat. We're good.
Okay. Well, these people, it's like opening the door and people have lived in their homes for 50 years and kicking them out. I don't want to do that. Now, there's other organizations that are looking possibly to organize, and the building is big enough, Plus, there's land there where they could, you know, set up something for them. And we're having the same problem over Bear Park.
Mm-hmm.
And we're trying to get that resolved. Now,
Where's Bear Park?
Bear Park, you don't know where it's at?
I don't.
Over the northwest section.
Okay.
You know where the school is, the northwest school?
Yes.
Right down from
there. Oh, okay. All right.
For years, that was getting run down. Well, the park. I umpired a lot of games there, believe me. And the ball club from out here stepped up to the plate, and they did the whole place over.
Okay.
The field, everything. It's beautiful. Now, there was a beautiful concession stand there, but it's always that when it's a volunteer group running organizations, you know, you have people that pass away or move or they get too old to do that. And it's tough to replace these people. So for the last couple of years, that concession stand has remained closed. But they were using the field house, but not for baseball.
Okay.
It was used as a area for our local boxers.
Oh.
I felt so bad for some of these parents that come in Monday night into council. And these aren't young parents. I mean, they're older, middle age. And they said they've seen such a tremendous change in their children. The one father stepped on it and he said, "My son was a bully. He was an outright bully, in trouble all the time.
Mm-hmm.
In school, getting in trouble, getting with the police and this and that. From the time that I introduced him to this organization, there's adults in there that watch. He has turned out to be a heck of a kid."
Well, good.
Helping other kids, his grades, you know, have
gone
up.
So this boxing is at Bear Park?
That's at Bear Park.
Okay, and the...
I would like to see that expanded out to East Ends.
Okay, yeah, that'd be great.
I know there is a club out there, too, at Pandora.
Okay, all right. Well, that's right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a stone's throw. They're one in the same.
That's right.
Yeah.
But let's look out for the kids in our community, okay?
Mm-hmm.
They're the next leaders, and you better understand that, whether you like it or not. They're going to be our next leaders, and I want some kids that know what's going on.
Yes.
Okay.
I agree.
Boards, authorities, and commission openings. I'm going to go down over this list. We still have time.
Mm-hmm.
The Pagoda Foundation. That's an organization that stepped up about 5 or 6 years ago, and they are doing a heck of a job.
Yeah.
I go up there every Saturday. I take my wife up. She's not doing too good, but she likes to go up there on a Saturday and visit.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm amazed at the amount of people that we have up there every Saturday. And these are not local people.
No, it's a place to go. It's a place to take visitors, for
it's
sure.
It's not a local people. Yeah. We have people from all over
mm-hmm.
coming in there. And Scotty up there, Kaufman, he introduces me.
Aww.
And they come over and talk to me, and they talk to my wife. And it's packed. And the places, they rent it out upstairs for mm-hmm. weddings,
okay.
get-togethers and everything. And people are amazed at the condition. Now, we're starting to have a problem again with that brick wall in front of the pagoda.
Oh, yes. Okay. Yep.
Periodically, that thing starts to deteriorate. And I personally think it's from all that moisture up there, because there is a lot of streams in that.
Oh, yeah.
But we did have it fixed a couple years ago. Now, we asked Ralph Johnson to take a good look at that repair job that was done to see if it was done properly or what the situation is. And he says he thinks it was done properly, but not to the extent that we
would have wanted it
would
to
have
be.
Wanted it.
Okay.
And I think we're right now trying to get that repaired.
Good.
But we're always doing something.
Good.
Okay, we need two people on that board. Two people. And they don't have regular meetings. They meet when needed.
Okay. So it's a way to give back to the community without some huge commitment.
Right.
Okay.
Fire Civil Service Board, we need one person there. I don't want to go into this. We are filling up all the vacancies right now in the fire department.
Great.
We just put on, I guess it was 10 or 12 new firemen.
Wonderful.
And we're only missing one person off that civil service board, and we'd like to fill that. This is another one, HARB. We need one person in the Penn Commons, one in the Prince area, and one at large. These are the people that take a look at all the neighborhoods to determine, are they deteriorating?
Okay.
If you want to do something, is it allowed to be done? Are you in the...
Oh, yeah, okay.
And we're not missing that many people, but we need three people. One in the Prince area, that's around City Park.
Mm-hmm.
Penn Commons, that's close by. And one at large.
Okay.
One to the library. Again, we've had that filled except for one person. I push this at every meeting we have, and it appears to help.
That's, oh, yeah.
One person.
Well, I mean, I think some people, they want to get involved. They're not sure how.
Yeah.
And this list, by the way, Strat's going over the list, but the guidebooks, if you want to hold that up, they're available here at BCTV, so you can see what all these different boards and authorities are. And if you want to see the openings or who has openings, you can just give Linda Kelleher a call, 610-655-6204. That's 655-6204. And she'll be able to take your offer of volunteering for any of these boards. So library. So now we're on Board of Health.
Okay, we need one person there, which isn't bad.
No.
At one time, we needed three and four people.
Yeah. And most of these don't meet regularly.
No,
or most
only
of them kind of as needed.
As
so
needed.
Again, it's not some huge weekly commitment. So,
Animal Control Board. What happened? The one individual, I think, passed away.
Okay.
And the other one moved from the area.
Okay.
And they only meet as needed. And actually, they work close with the Humane Society.
Right.
And they do a good job.
They do a good job.
Yep. Ooh, Charter Board. That's very important. Now, we lost some people there. One person now is a city councilman.
Okay.
And
he moved on up.
Yeah, and we need two people there. And that's an important board.
Yes.
Major changes that are going to take place in the city must go through the board.
Okay.
And we're looking for two people there. EAC, and I don't know what that is.
Okay, you're honest. But it's in the guidebook.
Yes, it's in the guidebook.
It'll be in the guidebook.
Redevelopment Authority 2, Planning Commission 2, Shade Tree Commission 2, Local Redevelopment 1. And I'll tell you, at one time, the redevelopment needed 5.
Wow.
Okay? But I'm going to get to this. Every time I come in here, I bring these in. Because people are looking for these.
They're amazing.
Everything you want to know about the city, taxes, parking, voting, volunteer work, parks and theaters, everything is in here. Please, they're right out here in the lobby. And I'll make it a point every time that I have a program that I will bring some of these along. Because they tell me they don't last long. Tomorrow, these will be gone.
They'll be gone.
But we printed hundreds of these, and they're terrific.
Is a lot of this information on the city website,
yes,
though?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Right. Yes. Boy, oh boy, we really went through there, didn't we?
Yeah, you did great. I think you hit on all the topics. Just to remind people, you're working on the VA hospital location,
yes.
Amendment to a stadium commission. Hopefully we'll see traffic lights at 5th and Ole and 5th and Douglas shortly. Great American Cleanup, April 23rd.
Mm-hmm.
Please get involved, even if you're not in the city. It's countywide. Alvernia Park, East Ends, and then the boards and authorities. Anything else you want to wrap up?
Wish everybody a nice Easter.
Oh, yes. Happy Easter to
Happy
everybody.
Easter.
Absolutely.
Well, now, my Easter is next month.
I was going to say, your Easter isn't when is
no.
in, yeah, so
Where
that's
am
all right.
We at? That was a long minute.
That was a long minute. I think we're good. So if you don't have anything else,
that's it.
We'll wish everybody a happy and good evening. And thank you for joining us. Good night.
Good night.